We have a lot of patients on the list who need an organ, and the idea of wasting an organ is a tragedy.
It's true for all organs that we have more recipients waiting than we have donors available. We need to be thinking outside the box about what's acceptable for organ transplantation.
For decades, we as a transplant community have always shuddered from accepting organs from hepatitis C donors.
The community did not want to expose our patients to the risks of those infections, in part because we didn't have treatments.
2015 was a very important year for hepatitis C because that's really when the treatment for hepatitis C was revolutionized. At the same time, what we were dealing with, unfortunately, was the increase in the IV drug use epidemic.
We've seen more and more hepatitis C positive donors during the current opioid crisis. There were many, many organs out there that we were declining. And putting that together with the fact that we now have highly effective therapy is what led to the light bulb going off.
Many centers began to adopt hepatitis C donors with the idea that if the disease developed, they would eliminate the disease. The problem is that the treatment is very, very expensive. The Brigham basically took this leap in developing an entirely new concept around it.
We've been working on this study for many years. We wanted to show that you could safely and effectively transplant hearts and lungs from donors who had active hepatitis C in a way that you could then block viral transmission in the recipient.
Do a short course of treatment of just a month. Treat them right then and there at the time the organ is placed, within hours, and block the virus from ever setting up shop.
The question was really, were these organs any different and would the outcomes be any different? We started to actually enroll the first patient at the end of March of 2017. Officially, it's almost 7 months since your transplant.
Yeah.
And are you continuing to do as well as you've been doing throughout?
Better. We hiked up a mountain the other day.
Some hiking.
If my lungs didn't pop then, they never would.
That's excellent. And from the hepatitis C perspective, everything couldn't be better.
Yeah.
The results of the study were exciting. We have now transplanted over 60 patients. To our knowledge, the largest prospective trial that has been done to date.
As the first few patients cleared the virus, and it stayed cleared, that was very powerful.
That virus essentially cleared within 2 weeks of initiating the therapy. In terms of their survival to 6 months, things look the same as our standard of care.
The use of this course of treatment is 100% effective. This is a game changer finding.
The impact of this study does more than just show, yes, this can be done. We were able to really design a trial that can be used at other centers to be able to impact more patients.
If even half the centers in the United States were to adopt the Brigham protocol, we would in fact shorten the time to transplantation by nearly half.
This is going to open up just a whole new world of access to organs.
You feel, looking back on it, that you made the right choice?
Oh, Lord, yes.
Yeah.
I'd do it again tomorrow.
It's my superhero now.
Hello, how are you doing? Good, nice to see you.
It's something that people just have to give full consideration to. Knowing the limited availability of donor organs that are out there, anybody that doesn't is shortchanging themselves.
Thank you for giving me back my life.
Well, we thank the donor family, right?
You guys.
Yes.
Oh,
they've sent us
in
lovely letters.
Them, so.
Oh, really? Have you been in touch?
Yes.
Oh, that's incredible. I think the wonderful thing is that it impacts the donor families as well. Just because their loved one did die from a drug overdose, their organs, which are otherwise medically suitable, are just as good as someone else's organs. I hope this helps to decrease the stigma of hepatitis C.
What we need to do in healthcare is understand that there is no treatment that doesn't have risk, but how does the risk weigh against the benefit? We will continue to find ways to extend our therapies to the next patient groups that we can extend it to, and that's the goal of what we do, is to improve the quality of life.